afternoon. Don, you are a great man. You're still lighting up your cigarette, but I know you are not sucking. You have become very cautious. And that is the beauty of cautiousness. When really become cautious, that's where we start awakening up. I want everybody to wake up America. That's my objective. Because the problem is, when I came to this country in 1967, the population of the United States was 150 million. And I was in Detroit, Michigan, coming from New Delhi, India, after finishing my medical college. And one day, I was standing on a bridge and watching the cars. And the cars are moving so fast, because at that time, Detroit was a car city. And every second or every minute, the cars were getting produced. Now that city is totally dead. The car industry is spread all over the world. When I came, we did not have the phone. I have to call home my father on a line, and that has to go to some other neighbor. In 5 minutes, he has to come there and then talk to me. Now you imagine, we got a cell phone. We got a voice line. We can talk to each other. I have people working in India. I'm talking to them every day on the voice line. Not only talking, but I can see each other. They can see me and I can see them. It is tremendous, the material world, the Western science has given us all the things, luxuries. But we have forgotten ourselves, who we are. If we realize ourselves that we are nothing, and we wake up because we are daydreaming and sleeping and self-hypnosis, and we have made ourselves totally conditioned, and we have become a robot because we go and work for somebody. And what we are doing? We are trying to make money. $10, $20, $15 an hour. Are this body worth of that? No. I want you to start realizing. That's my purpose is. Wake up, all of you. Wake up, America. These series of talk which I am giving you, I'm giving you my experience. But you have to practice, because the person sitting inside of you, that's the consciousness which I'm talking, the watcher. Watcher is always in the present. Just like our body's instinct, watcher is always in the present. And if you become a watcher of this body, that means you are sitting outside the body. You become the controller of this body. And naturally, you control your mind and the complex senses and the body, the whole body itself. It's a one organic unit. And it's totally orgasmic. Because as you see me, I'm laughing. Because I feel myself being myself. I am beyond the intuition. And that's what I want you to do that. And the only way you can do it, you have to take responsibility of yourself. You have to look at yourself. You are looking everything outside through your eyes. You're hearing from outside. You're smelling from outside. Have you turned your just inside yourself and closed your eyes? Everything is sitting inside of you. You are the king. Vivekananda said that I'm a god. And he said, you are also a god. Problem is, you are not big, you are not aware of yourself. Once you become aware of yourself, each one of us is a God. There is no God sitting outside. It's a fear. Even Gautam Buddha said, there is no God. It is big. Even Jesus said, the kingdom of heaven is inside of you, and that's what we all have. He did not say that I'm the only one to have a kingdom from heaven. Guru Nanak said the same thing. He said, he taught about Satnam, the truth, Kartapurakh, existence has no fear, nirvair, no animosity with anybody. It's pure truth, such, just now is whatever is gone is also a truth. Ad such, jugad such, epi such. This is today, is truth, is present. What is wrong, what is gone is also truth, and what is going to happen is truth. Because we are living with our emotions and ideas and thoughts, and we have totally engulfed ourselves and we have crippled ourselves. And that's why we are producing a disease. Mind is a disease. Mind is anxiety. Mind is a sickness. Mind is a cancer. Mind is a malignness. And the question is, how do you go out of this mind? And that is by becoming the watcher. And once you become a watcher, and that is the awakening. And that's, once you become conscious of that, and you keep practicing it every day, pretty soon, the watcher becomes so strong, it becomes 100% conscious, and you become, and you transcend from that mind, and you become total awareness. And that's where every one of you want to be. And it may seem very difficult, but it's very easy. Because you are not paying, you are totally crippled with your total conditioning, and you are used to this every day, breakfast, lunch, and dinner, going to work every day, slaves, and same thing about the becoming financially freedom. The only way you can become financially freedom is, first you look at yourself. You don't need a lot of money to live. How much fruit you can eat, how much vegetable you can eat. You need a one place, a bed to sleep, couple clothes to wear. You work every day. If I am in that situation, I work in the farm. Every day physically I will use my body, which I do it now anyway. You can ask Don, you know that. Amen. I come and work with you, yes, because I love it. And that's where we are sitting in the form, the existence, and that I'm getting awakened every second. And if you ask me, do I know anything? I really don't know. And that is the problem. As soon as I say I know, I have crippled myself. The thing which is scientist, which is unknown yesterday, it is known today. But the existence, totally unknown. We are talking about Democratic and Republic elections. And look at that Democratic, how they are fighting with each other when they go on a stage, the debate. It's basically sad. And they are cutting each other's throat. Is that a life? It is literally a shame on all these people hurting themselves. They have forgotten who they are. If each one of us is a living temple and the God is sitting in each one of us, why should we fight with anybody? We should have no ego, no competition, no pride. Just the love which we should love ourselves. And if we become totally unconditional consciousness, and that is unconditional love, then we'll have no problem. We'll be living happy, healthy, and without any stress. And I want to share with you the book which I just wrote, it called The Cancer Cure Without Chemotherapy and Radiation. Please go to our website and register yourself and get this book free of charge. And if you have any question about financials, about medical, or any other question, any other problem with your family, please write to us. We'll be happy to help you and discuss with you and solve that problem. We are here for your service at no charge. But make sure when you change your lifestyle, you work with your health practitioner so that you can get the best result. I wish you all a happy day. God bless. Namaste. Amen.